You won't find a cast of characters like this everywhere.
Hello, Paul.
I'll go anywhere for a potato.
Delicious.
This particular episode of the Shy Life is a little more abstract than usual.
Okay, it looks like the hairy guy is ready to record. 3, 2, 1.
Go Shy Yeti.
Oh, I hope he hasn't found out my secret. I think he has.
Hello and welcome to another episode of the Shy Life podcast with me, Paul the Shy Yeti. How are you doing? I'm all right. Yeah. Yeah. It's my birthday. Sorry, I had a bit of a cold. I can't do the woohoos very well. So, what am I doing this episode for my birthday? And for Fake's birthday. Well, actually, he isn't around. He's gone to a big party in space. I mean, it's the last thing I expected to hear. I mean, considering that he's only a month or so away from giving birth, I kind of thought, well, anyway, apparently it's allowed, but it's happening on a planet where, well, we couldn't have gone with him, basically. It wouldn't have worked. Hopefully we'll have a message from him. Yeah. Anyway, let me get on with things. I'll run the theme music, and then when we come back, I'll tell you more about what's going on this episode. Yeah. Okay, run that theme music, please. Anyone? Somebody? Anyone? Right.
Mm-hmm. It's time for my old buddy, old pal, from across the channel, across the pond. Paul Chandler, the Shy Yeti.
He's not that shy.
Oh, it's the Shy Yeti podcast.
All I wanted was a pie,
and then I hatched out of an egg.
Okay, bring the mic over. He's ready to record.
It's the quiet ones you've got to watch, you know.
Is it metaphorical? Is it deep? Is it deep?
Good boy. He's had all that shy and bright.
Blimey, Governor. It's the Shy Life Podcast.
If you thought that was bad, just listen to this.
Oh, I can't wait. I can't wait for it to begin.
It's the Shy Life Podcast.
He's positively glowing.
It's all gooey and meaty and yum, 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 yum.
So, yes, here we are. It's my birthday and, kind of getting over a cold, but, what can I report? Oh well, I'm in a lovely house. Yeah, I thought as I had no plans, and it wasn't going to be easy to do anything with Toby because, well, you know, we have to make our own plans these days because of Dealey, and of course Callum doesn't live with us anymore, so we haven't got a cat sitter, so we can't have holidays together. So I just decided I would just book something short notice. Yes, I booked a big spooky manor house in the countryside. Yeah, seemed like a good idea at the time. You know, it's not that it's scary. You know me, I don't mind scary. It's not really that. It's more than it's a bit boring. Yeah, I guess I don't really feel like I've got that much energy after my cold anyway. And it is cold outside. But, you know, I've got food. I had a lovely chicken pie earlier with mash and veg, and had some Viennese cake. Yeah, you know, things are... I guess I'm kind of a little bit taken aback by Ick not being here, because I thought, if anything, it would be lovely to, do a joint birthday with him, because last year, you know, I forgot, and this year he's made his own plans, and we can't do something together. Never mind. We did have a message from him.
Hello, Paul. It's me, Ick the Alien. Sorry I can't be with you this year. Hope you have a lovely birthday. I'm sure I'll have a lovely birthday. I'm going to a big party in space. I would have invited you, but you just wouldn't cope with the atmospheric pressure. Sorry. Have a great time. Bye for now. It's me, Ick the Alien. Goodbye.
Bit brief. So I booked this big scary house, and I thought that some of the others might come with me, including friends of the show. I asked Harry if he would like to come, but he couldn't get the time off work. Same with Callum. Nick, he does his washing on a Wednesday, so he couldn't come. Cromarty and Martin, Sniffy Martin, were on some sort of course, yeah, like a one-day course. I mean, they could have come down before or afterwards, but... Not even sure what the course is about. Something to do with stuff. I don't know, computer stuff, maybe. I mean, August Evans, August Damis, August... he's doing stuff with Bettina. I'm not even sure what. Of course, Yeti Uncle John's still in shame jail. I kind of left to my own devices. I need to go and close the curtains. What I have got, though, is I've got presents and cards to open. So we'll do that in a minute. I've got some Sutton Park clips as well. What else? Oh, I said to Toppy that I'd give him a call and see how he was. He's always entertaining. He's always very good, value for money when it comes to banter and chatter in birthday episodes. So, we'll call Toppy in a bit. Something. Right. Title. Ouch. Sorry. Ow, what's happening? Oh. Sorry, listeners. It's kind of dark outside. I've wasted most of my birthday. I didn't even go down to the shops or anything. It just looked cold. I had some cider, only one bottle, and when I say bottle, it's just one little bottle. But I've been drinking it very slowly, a tiny swig, at a tiny, yeah, tiny, tiny, tiny. I got some gin. Came in the post, you know, Amazon. Couldn't believe it. It was from Milo, my friend Milo. Little Milo, who likes giants. He sent me He sent me he sent me a bottle of Tarquin's Cornish dry gin. Now it makes sense that he asked me where I was going on holiday, because he was sending me this gin. Oh, so my small bottle of cider does not matter, because Milo's cider got here unexpectedly. I haven't got a mixer, but I'm sure I have a mixer in the fridge, even if it's orange juice or something. Yes, thank you to Milo. Very, very kind, very lovely. Thank you. Right. Oh, here's some cards. Let's have some cards. I have got some presents. Some of them are for my mum. Not that that's a bad thing. Right. This one. What's this one? Oh, moon pig. Moonpig.com. Oh, happy birthday to a rare bear, Paul. It's Paddington. To Paul, wishing you a very happy birthday. Have a lovely day. Love, Lisa, Andrew, Rose, and Martha. Oh, that's a good card. Anything with Paddington on is always a good card. Here's another card. Ooh, little kitty poking out of a latte cup. Dear Paul, thought this was so cute. Miss, wishing you a wonderful birthday with love from Anita and Chris and Sam. Anita was my boss back in the days when the library was worth working in. Another one. This is for my uncle and aunt. Ooh. Yes. Happy birthday from Uncle Dennis, Auntie Sheila and Stephen. And it's got money in it. Money, money. £20. Very kind. Very nice. This looks like Callum's writing. It's a cat. My uncle and aunt's card, there's a boat, some boats, like a painting of some boats. This is of a cat. Two people wishing you a very happy birthday, Callum and Sheila. Yeah. That's a good cat card. This looks like a Wifey Joe card. Got lots of Converses, or like cartoon drawings, different colours, Converse. Dear hubby number one, wishing you a very happy birthday with lots of lovely things and cake and maybe a cheeky gin and tonic. Lots of love, Wifey and Rob. Yes, I think that might be her real husband. I know who Rob is. It is. To Paul. This is from Toby. Happy birthday. It's Moomins. Happy birthday. Sorry I couldn't be with you today. Lots of love. Toby. Yeah, well, it was good. It means that Dealey gets to be looked after, and we can't really complain about that. So, what's this? Oh, there's lots of stickers on this one. I wonder if this is from Kerry's wife, Jessie. I'm really guessing. Lots of cats. Have a perfect birthday. Yes, to Paul, happy birthday. Lots of love, Becky and George. She has used some good stickers. Stickers all over. Sorry, just trying to guess handwriting. I feel like I should know this. Should know this one. Might even have one more, one or two more. You know, catch me up later on. As this is, I'm recording this actually, you know, on my birthday. Happy cake day, enjoy. This is from Michelle, Ray and Yasmin. Michelle, who I used to work with. Yes, that's why I should recognise her handwriting. Although I haven't worked with her for over 21 years, we have continued to send Christmas and birthday cards every year since we left. So, very nice. Happy birthday from all the cats. It says, dear Paul, have a fabulous birthday. Lots of love from Julie, Peter, Corey and Elsa. That's their cats. I think this is from Rosemary. I used to work with. A big grey cat looking at a goldfish and going sort of cross-eyed. So it's actually, it's not an illustration. It's a photo. To Paul, happy birthday. Hope you're having a good day. Best wishes, Rosemary. Hope you're keeping well. That's debatable. This is from Mum and Dad. Quite a good card. Picked this one up last time I saw them. It's a panda. Happy birthday from Mum, Dad, Megan and Amy. Beth's thinking about it. Yeah, well, Beth makes her own rules. And there's another check. I shall pop those into the bank tomorrow. Well, I don't actually have to go to the bank. I just have to pop them in electronically.
Hello again, listeners. It is I, Robot Cuthbert. I just wanted to pop in quickly to wish Paul a very happy birthday. Happy birthday! Exclamation. I can't stay long as I have to nip up into space for Rick's special outer space birthday party. Sadly, most of the regulars can't attend, but luckily I can go because I'm a robot. You've probably noticed that already. Anyway, before we hear more from Paul, here is a new song that our good friend Harry wrote for us. It's called Feeling Again. Enjoy! Exclamation.
Toppy, it's me, Paul. How are you doing?
I'm good. Hey, Paul, good to hear from you. And a happy birthday.
Oh, thank you. Thank you for remembering. I'm away for my birthday. I'm having a little holiday. You know, that's what I usually do, although for the last couple of years it's not been possible. But
womp womp to that. But where the heck are you this time?
I'm down in Colchester. It's just a part of the UK, but anyway, it's exciting at the moment, you know, having only just got back into travelling around a bit. But I'm by myself. I mean, that's kind of why it's nice to be able to talk to you and just sort of have a little chat. Because
you're like in a hotel or something?
No, I'm in like an old house. I've been here before. I went here about 2 years, like 2019. But that time I was with Toby. But of course, back then, Callum was still living with us and he was able to look after Dealey. But now Callum's living with his mum and he can't really look after Dealey. We booked this holiday before we realized.
I just heard like a squeaky door open. Who's there with you?
I don't know. Maybe it's just the wind. It's probably just the wind.
Okay. Because you said you were alone.
I think it must just be the wind. There's so many doors that are open and the windows open. So last time I came with Toby, but it's just not been possible this year. So I'm here for a few days and then we'll swap over. And Toby will come here by himself, and I'm just going to be recording, you know, podcasts and things.
Yeah, yeah.
The way you do.
Yeah, I always like the way you head off somewhere on your birthday.
There's actually a possibility that Harry might turn up, but he's not sure if he can get the time off. So I'm expecting to hear from him a little bit later. He'll just come down for the day, but it'll be nice if he can come. If he can't, I won't be too disappointed. I know it's a difficult ask at the moment. But
mm-hmm. So I can't remember now. What do you got? Like you rent a room? You got a room?
No, so I've got the whole house and there's like two bedrooms and there's a kitchen and a lounge. But these particular houses, they don't have like internet or TV. Although I can have my laptop and I've got my mobile, which has got internet, but it's a little bit more cut off. Although I'm actually right in a town, so I could walk outside and just down the road, there's a cinema. And if I walked the opposite direction, there's another cinema. So, you know, it's pretty civilized, really. And there's a park and of course this time of year the leaves are changing. It looks very, very lovely.
This is my favorite time of year.
It's just, you know, a little bit weird being by yourself sort of in a strange town though.
you've been you're used to it. What's so strange about it? What's the matter?
Well, it's quite an old house, so, you know.
Oh, just, well.
Mine starts to work, but it's like, you mentioned the sound of the creaky door.
What I thought I heard.
Yeah, I just, you know, I must remember to check all the doors before I go to bed, because I don't want burglars getting in or anything. I'm not saying there will be burglars, but you just don't know, and usually I've got Toby and Dealey here to protect me.
You need to, you know, you need to be safe.
I'm sure I'm just being, you know, silly. I'm sure I must have just left a window open, you don't mind if I call you again, whilst I'm here, just to kind of check in with you and just tell you what's up to maybe, or.
You call me anytime you want.
You begin to imagine things. It's weird because, you know, even Yeti Uncle John, you know, everyone, I haven't been able to, Yeti Uncle John can't come because he's still in shame jail for another few weeks. It's heavily pregnant and is due any day now.
I just don't like the way you said heavily pregnant. Oh, God. What is he going to birth, Paul?
I'm not sure. Because Cromarty wants to stay near him, and Martin wants to keep an eye on August. But I mean, the one good thing, I don't know what will come of it, even though August seems to be very much still August rather than Damius, he and Patina are spending more time together. She seems to have found peace with whatever the situation is, and he seems to be genuinely, even though it's like he's only just met her rather than having all this history with her, but he seems to genuinely like her company. So things are kind of working out in a weird way. But
it is weird. I mean, I don't know. It's just like, I mean, I suppose he could be August for the rest of his life.
There have been a few things that have been happening, which I'm sure you've heard about, which it does seem like, rather than showing their hand in a very sort of blatant way, we're finding out things we thought were true aren't true, and that perhaps Control Incorporated are involved. Yeah. So they're still meddling, but hopefully it's getting less and less.
Oh, good Lord, that Control Inc. We were swamped in that ourselves over in Pickle Hollow. I think we've divested, you know, and I'm so glad that that was troublesome, Paul. Troublesome.
But I mean, it's nice for August that he is still able to, you know, because I know he's been back once, twice since that original first visit, and he has his Pickle Hollow following with his art. So it's nice for him that he's able to, you know, if he's going to have a totally different personality, that he's actually got one that it seems to have brought a new talent out of him, which we didn't know about.
Oh, yeah. And also, you know, I'm sure Jose and Walt have said thanks themselves, but, you know, he's still sending the occasional painting over here for them to put in their restaurant. So there's still, you know, some new work hanging. Yeah.
Anyway, I suppose I better go and make some dinner or something, and just in case Harry's trying to call as well. So,
okay,
I'll speak to you sort of tomorrow or something like that. And all right. Yeah, you take care.
Well, happy birthday again. Have fun.
Bye. Okay, bye now. Bye.
Bye. Bye.
Hello, it's me again, Robot Cuthbert. Before we continue with Paul's birthday celebration, I just wanted to share with you more clips from Sutton Park from April 1994 from around episodes 407 to 411. There are quite a few special guests and all manner of mysterious goings on. I hope you enjoy our dip into the archives. We're hoping to share the video version eventually, so keep an eye out on our Mr. Shy Yeti YouTube channel over the next few months! Exclamation.
Do not worry. They have gone. You will be safe with me. Safe with me.
Edith! I don't understand, Robert. Who is this woman? Do you remember anything about her at all?
No, not a thing.
What is she? Looks like she wiped your mind or something. She obviously wanted Harry for some reason, or the robot Harry, or whatever.
But why?
I don't know.
Maybe it's just a stuffed dummy with a motor and a robot brain.
Does she know that? Well, whoever she is, she's obviously something to do with Sutton Park.
That's one of Laura's prototypes. Laura's going to kill me when she finds out.
Well, it's too late. Where did she have a car?
I don't know. All I can remember is a silvery shimmer. I think something she had was silver.
Come on, we're going to have to walk. We're going to have to walk into town, see if we can catch up with her. I don't know. See if we can. I don't know. Well, if we go out in the back of the house, we can get on the path and get it through the woods, back into town that way.
Yeah, I might get Laura to trace him again.
Yeah, come on. Dude, this is typical. It's,
It's more trouble than he's alive.
Yeah, if we come down the side. Robin? Robin?
Yeah?
Robin? Sorry, I'm just trying to work out the way.
This way?
Just trying to work out the way through your... Which way is this way to your house, Sis?
Yeah, this way to my house. Then we can get to Laura, then we can find out the beach.
Yeah. The weather's taken a bit of a turn for the worse, though, isn't it?
Oh, it's dreary.
I know. It's not the best day. It's not the best day for walking. Should have taken the bus if we'd had the chance, you know.
Yeah, God. There's always excess baggage slowing you down if you
can. I'm worried, just worried about,
Harry.
Harry, yeah.
I understand that. I thought by now I'd have got used to people trying to influence my mind.
Well, we didn't know. I mean, I just wonder who this woman was. That's all.
All I can remember is silvery.
I don't think there was a car. I never saw a car go past, so I don't know if a car did actually come.
Well, I certainly didn't see a car, but I reckon I don't know how long I was
there. Well, I mean, if it's something to do with something apart, she was just transported away. I mean, at least she hasn't got the real... It's only a robot, but it's a pretty... You know,
if she transported, I ought to have found a trace of her.
Yeah, once we found all of it. Oh, dear. Anyway, I sort of recognise this part of it, but...
It does bring back memories, which is odd, I've been here for years.
Yes, there's the woods over there. Oh, yeah, I called up, whilst I went in to get the bus timetable, I popped in, I told my boss that I wouldn't be coming in today, and she said that it was okay, but anyway, it was Saturday.
Yes, it is Saturday, Paul, you don't need to go in.
Yeah, it's pretty strange, it being Saturday, because, well, last time I remember it being a day, it was another day, and it wasn't, I'm sure there hasn't been that many days in between last time I told them the date. When I told the viewers the date last time, it was sort of earlier in the week, and the days just seem to have gone past, and I was surprised it was Saturday.
Flash you by like an early summer's morning.
Yeah. So I've actually started on Monday.
Right.
It was really weird, because whilst I was on the phone, I had a haircut.
That is weird.
Yeah, I don't know, I just looked in the mirror on the way out, and I've got a haircut now. You'll see it later, viewers, I've got a haircut.
Why did you have a haircut?
I don't know, this woman...
I personally like hairs as they are, I think going around cutting them is cruel.
Yeah.
I prefer a rabbit.
Well, I was just standing in the kitchen, this woman came up to me and said it was like a haircut.
Yeah.
Actually, she had a silver thing with her.
What is that?
You don't think the woman who came to cut my hair could be the woman who...
Silver?
Silver, she had like a silver.
What thing?
I don't know, a silver thing. She had a silver thing. Maybe it was the person who took Harry. Had to cut my hair.
Must be.
Come on. Look. Are you okay with the camera?
I don't know. Does this pink button do anything?
You better not touch it.
Oh.
There's my haircut. I don't know if you can see it.
It looks really cool. Where did you have that cut then?
Oh, I don't know. Where did I have my haircut? I had it cut on the phone by the woods.
Yes, I remember now. Hey, you've gone off the camera.
On this way.
That way.
You're supposed to be going through the woods.
Be careful.
Going through the woods.
Okay.
How do you manage this? It's just so slippery. Wait for me.
Turn it off and I'll take the camera back again.
Thank you.
I sense intruders in the secret forest. Yes. There are definitely intruders. I recognize them both. They have been seen here before.
Shall we kill them? Their bodies would make good compost.
No! Wait, I have a
pull. I'm coming.
We nearly gave ourselves away. No, we must wait. I have a plan.
Robin! Oh, I thought I'd lost you. Oh, I got a bit lost. You shouldn't have come. I should have got a bit of water on my...
Yeah,
the weather's got a bit bad.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm losing my way back down here. I do recognise these woods, though. I didn't think I'd been here for ages, but...
You sure?
I vaguely remember coming here a matter of days ago, I came here and I bumped into somebody. I can't remember. What about you? Have you been here before? You look confused.
I don't think so.
Oh, come on, it's this way.
Yeah?
Oh. I just hope Laura's in when we get to your house.
Oh, I hope so too.
This is...
There's something odd about this place, you know. It's supposed to be a bridle path.
It's supposed to be a bridle path, just a dirty old footpath.
Yeah, but there aren't any horses prints here, are there?
No, just a minute, Robin.
What?
Look. Down there, there's...
What?
There's something down there. It's weird.
Oh.
Robin, I remember this.
Oh, God, we've got to get out of here quickly.
Robin, what is this? I remember it, though. I don't know what it is.
I don't know how I could have forgotten it. It's some sort of radioactive container.
A radioactive container from space or something?
Yes.
You've been here before, then. You have been here.
Yeah,
you've seen
I don't
it here.
I forgot. Just a minute.
Robin.
What?
Does that mean we came into this wood at some... You said you came into this wood at some time and...
Yes.
And your memory's been wiped.
Yes. We've got to get out this
I was here. I remember. You know I said I was here?
It's radioactive.
Yes, well, I know I was here. We've got to find out what it's doing. I came here, I bumped into my friend Paul, and then I stumbled upon this, and then I went out, I found this. Oh, God, this... Quick, get out!
They have made a big mistake, but I have a plan. I know what I will do with them.
Shall we kill them? Shall we stab them? Shall we hurt them? Shall we mutilate them?
No. No. I have another plan. We will not kill them. We will make them like us. They will grow into trees. They will be our servants.
I can't breathe, Robin. I can't breathe.
What is happening to them?
Do not fear. They are not dying. They are taking in the lethal dose of radiation. They will grow now.
Yes.
Within 6 months, they will be like us. They will slowly grow roots and become like us.
Robin, I think...
I can't teleport.
You can't teleport? Oh, God. Actually... I feel a bit better. What was that? Did we take in some sort of lethal dose of radiation or something?
I don't know.
Well, shall we go and see a doctor or something?
I think we ought to.
Right, we better find our way out quickly.
Yeah.
Oh my God. Oh, very dangerous. We've got to go and warn the police as well.
Warn the police. You will forget everything. You will come back and join us soon. We wait for your return.
This way, I think we must get to the police.
Yeah.
Get ourselves to the doctors.
The doctor.
We've got to warn them about...
Radiation.
Warn them about the radiation. There's radiation in the woods.
Yeah. Like Bruce Banner.
Bruce Banner?
Yeah, like...
Who's he? He's the Incredible Hulk. Bruce Banner. Yeah. It's like Bruce Banner. We tell them it's like Bruce...
I never...
What are we
going to
tell them? Stop. What are we telling them? What are we telling the police? I can't remember. We're telling them there's woods. We're going to tell them there's woods.
Talk about Bruce Banner. What are you on about?
We're going to the doctors. Dr. Bruce Banner.
Yeah, Dr. Bruce Banner. He's
we're
in the
going
Incredible
to the
Hulk.
Woods. We're going to talk. Who are we talking to? We're talking.
We're in the woods and we're talking about Dr. Bruce Banner.
Have I got to go home now then? Why am I coming with you? Why am I here? You're nearly. Why have I walked to the way? Why am I here? Dr. Bruce Banner. I'm here because of him. No, he's an
Incredible Hulk. I'm not sure.
I was walking you home.
Yeah.
What about?
You must have been.
Harry. Harry's Dr. Bruce. I don't. Harry. No.
Harry.
I don't know. There was something about Harry.
I can't remember. The last time I remember
Harry, he was going to escape from us. He was going to escape.
Yeah. You remember?
No.
He ran off from us. Yeah. Somehow his motor went running and haven't seen him since.
Haven't seen him for ages.
No.
That's all right then.
Yeah.
Right. So you're going home?
Yeah.
And I'm going home?
Well, I know you're walking me home.
But it's nearly there now. You're nearly home.
Yeah,
it's...
you're right. You might as well go back then.
Yeah, I'll go back because it's raining.
Well, I don't really think going back this way is the right way. I don't know why.
And my
another way.
My camera's getting wet.
Yeah, why don't we go back another way?
No, oh.
Yes, it's getting wet.
Camera's getting wet. I'll go home separately then.
Yeah.
I'll go home now.
Okay.
Well, have fun.
Yeah.
And I'll see you when I see you.
Yeah.
Dr. Bruce Banner.
No. We were talking about him. I'm not him.
Oh.
I'm Robin.
Okay, then. Bye then.
Bye.
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 So, I'm going home to... I'm home going to... yeah.
On the way home. Home on the open range now.
Fools! They are all fools! But they will return and be like us! Like us!
I'm going home. I'm going home because it... I'm going home.
You're hamming it up. You're hamming it up with Big Fatty. Oh, he is fat and thin. And oh, you still talk to him. And I don't know why. But you're hamming it up with Big Fatty.
Hi, Big Fatty.
Hi.
It's me, Paul the Shy Yeti.
Hi, how are you?
I'm out and about again.
Out and about?
I'm in the same park I was in my last message.
Oh, yes.
But it's exactly a week later.
Oh, and it's not creepy.
It's still nice and sunny.
Yes, lovely.
Actually, it was a bit breezy when I first got here, but
yes.
I think the trees are sort of sheltering me. It's very nice, though.
Lovely.
It is nice to...
just get out.
Sort of...
You can get out.
Be... Yeah. It's such a wide open space with trees and squirrels and
The squirrels.
People walking their dogs.
Oh,
and
people walking their squirrels.
Yeah, it's worth travelling that bit further.
Yes.
Compared to where I can walk near my flat.
Yes.
But I don't really have any news.
Okay.
And such.
That's fine.
Since my last message, I just wanted to check in really.
Well, it's lovely. Lovely that you did that. Yeah.
I've got a few more things sort of.
What?
Going on in the next few weeks.
Okay.
Going back to visit my parents, and then I'm going away for my birthday.
Oh, the hats, yes.
The start of November.
Oh, yes, that's nice.
Unfortunately,
mm-hmm.
I have to go by myself. I'm having, Toby and I are having to swap over because Dealey the cat is far too old to go into a kennel, and he's far too angsty.
Kind of like Granny.
We can't really leave him.
No, we can't leave him anywhere.
Because of COVID, my other flatmate, Callum, had to go back to live with his mum because his mum's not well.
Oh, no.
And I haven't got any friendly neighbours who can pop in, unless you could nip over. You know, just quickly, you don't mind feeding my cat, do you?
No.
Squeaky kitty, you do it, won't you? You're a kitty.
I'll send the nip over. How's that?
Poodle might not want to.
No,
she's not a dog.
No. Yes.
But, you know, anyway, yes, we can't go together because Dealey can't be left.
No.
For very long.
Right.
So I think we're going to have one night where we cross over.
Uh-oh.
Where,
a little crossover.
But anyway, I have plans.
Okay.
I have plans for my birthday, even though I'll be by myself.
Yes, that'll be.
It'll be good.
A week from
it'll
today.
Be nice to be somewhere different, and I'll have you, Big Fatty, and all the listeners to speak to, and I've got my listeners I can speak to.
Yes.
So yeah.
It'll be lovely.
I think that's about it, really.
Yes.
I'm going to continue enjoying.
Some cake.
The sunshine. I bought a little picnic lunch.
Oh, a little picnic.
Just some cheese, just some crackers.
Oh.
I've got a flask of coffee.
Oh.
And a flask of lemon.
Lemon.
A hot lemon drink.
Hot lemon drink.
It's not actually as cold as I thought it was going to be, but still, it's good to come prepared.
Oh, always prepared. Like,
there's a coffee shop in the middle of this park.
Oh, there is.
Anyway, right, I'll say goodbye.
Can you get some cake
there?
With
you. and more soon.
Okay.
Okay. Bye bye for now.
Thank you for calling. Bye. Y'all, that of course is Paul the Shy Yeti. And Shy Yeti, thank you so much for the call. Always lovely to hear from you. And you mentioned that you've got the celebration of exiting the birth canal coming up a week from today. And, you know, and there's nothing wrong with having a birthday all to yourself. It can be nice and reflective and just, y'all, sometimes a little, you know, this is one thing that the NIP has said to me. He goes, oh, I don't see how you are just content with just sitting on the porch and just being in your routine and doing the same kinds of things. And y'all, I just love it. I love it. It sounds to me like the Shy Yeti is enjoying that routine of going to that park. Big Fatty, you know, as Dr. Stone said in the Twitty, you know, on Halloween, it's okay for old, creepy old men to hand out candies to children any other time. Call the authorities. It's true. So, Shy Yeti, make sure you don't get the authorities called on you. Big Fatty, those birds in the background will keep him in line.
Hi, Toppy, it's me, Paul. I know it's quite well. It's quite late here. It may not be quite as late with you, but I can't sleep. I got this sort of silly thing, you know, the whole business about the creaky door. I went and locked all the doors, and there I was reading a book, and I heard a creaky door. I thought, well, just a minute, how can there be a creaky door if I've closed all the windows? And I for the life of me, I Toppy, what if it's zombies? What are zombies?
Zombies, Paul. Oh. This is unlike you. You've been no. you it's fine. You know, old places creak. You know, it's normal.
There is a cellar, but it's meant to be locked. And what if it's a zombie down in the cellar or a burglar?
Paul, it's, you know, I think you're just overwrought, and maybe you've been there by yourself for too long. Because really, I mean, a zombie.
I did have a cheese sandwich quite late before I went to bed, or tried.
Well,
to
there you go. There you go.
And I had a double espresso. That's probably all it is. Usually, that doesn't bother me. That sort of thing doesn't bother me. But
no, so I'm really surprised.
You don't think it's zombies then?
Well, no, I really I mean, it's an old place that creaks. You know, I mean, if it makes you feel better, go down and make sure the cellar door is locked, you know.
Yeah, maybe. Oh, well, sorry about this. I didn't want to bother you. You set me straight. You made me feel, you know.
Well, I hope so.
I got a little bit carried away.
But, make you feel better. It's good. I wouldn't worry about it, you know.
Yeah.
You hang up with me and, like, take some Big Fatty go-to-bed pills.
Oh, yeah.
And, you know, just have a nice, good night's sleep. It'll just be better in the morning.
Yeah, I'll do that. I'll give you a call in the morning. Well, I'll wait until you're awake. But
thank you.
I'll just let you know everything's okay.
All right.
Okay. Sorry about that, Toppy.
No, it's okay. It's all right.
Yeah. Okay. Well, night night then.
Okay. Good night.
Bye now. Bye.
Bye bye.
Oh, presents. There's another card, but I'll get to it when I get to it. This is my mum, I think. Mum and dad. It's handkerchiefs. It's the traditional handkerchiefs. Thank you. It looks like a pencil case, but I don't know if it would be. Or is it too bad? Oh no, it's little jams, I think.
six little jams, apricot, orange and malt whiskey, strawberry and champagne, raspberry and cassis. Four jams. I thought it said, oh no, it's 6 ounces. Okay. Now I understand. This is a book. Tap, tap, tap. This is another one for Mum and Dad. I think I only had three for Mum and Dad because I had the check. But my mum is lovely in a way. It's just that I have something to open up. A book about gin, a toast to the most aromatic spirits. Historic book, like history of gin book, which is good. And one of my gin that Milo sent me is in that book. We'll have a look later. These are from Nick. This is the card from Nick and Ali. The cat on the two cats watching box sets. To Paul, happy birthday. Have a great day. Yeti hugs from Nick and Ali. Nice. The film called The Monster, which is also known as I Don't Want to Be Born, with Joan Collins. I have it on DVD, but this is a new Blu-ray version. So, yes, not everyone's idea of birthday night watching, but yeah. That's what I'll be watching later. Oh, I've been very slow today to watch anything. You know, the equipment is here, but yes. Well, they're both short. I was going to watch an Amicus film, which I could probably fit this in, and Amicus film and the. And the monster. I don't know why they insist on calling it the monster. I don't want to be born. It's sort of like a sort of like an omen, sort of exorcist-y type filmy thing. Joan Collins, Ralph Bates, Eileen Atkins, and Donald Pleasance. Here's a book. This is from Nick and Ali. I haven't been asking for books, physical books, as much. But yes, this is David Sedaris's A Carnival of Snackery. And it's the second of his diaries, goes up to 2020. So I have the first one, and I have that in like book form, so I thought I might as well ask the other half in book form too. I am finding that I'm reading things on my phone that I've downloaded as ebooks far more than I am reading physical books these days, but yes, considering how many I have, this one's definitely a present. It's from my friend Simon. And then the other two records I've got here are a gift to myself. Thank you.
Oh, he's very good climbing here. Could have just sent this. He could have just sent this in the directly from Amazon, but he wanted to wrap it. And then the weird thing was, when I was at my parents, we had there was the paracut, and then there was all manner of problems with trains. And in the end, Simon came to my rescue and took me home. So he could have, had we known that he was going to, we were going to actually meet up, he didn't post it at all. But these things happen unexpectedly. So yes, so this is a card from Simon. Aww. Two cute cats dressed like Batman and Superman. Too poor. Have a fab day. Love, Simon. Aww. These cats dressed up as superheroes are extremely, they're very relaxed looking. They obviously don't mind dressing up as superheroes. And the actual present is a record. Nice paper. Anyway, I think I know what it is because he did ask me what I wanted. I know he wanted to buy me. Well, one of. You know, I said I bought myself a present. Well, I think he would have. I think Simon would have liked to have bought me one of those presents, but I'd already bought them, so. It is the first album by Garbage, which came out in 1995. It's on pink vinyl. It's got Only Happy When It Rains and Stupid Girl, etc. I saw them live around the time this album came out. So it seemed like a nice one to ask for, as I didn't have it on my in my collection already. Well, obviously I do in I do on CD, but not on vinyl. Now, this is my treat. Well, there's two of them. It's the new ABBA album. It's different artwork, yellow vinyl. And yes, I think Simon would have liked to have bought me this. But as I say, the moment I saw it advertised, I ordered it before I realised Simon even wanted to buy me something. Toby bought me a book. All about it's called Get Back, about the Beatles, a particular recording session. So it's a good coffee table book. There's quite a lot to look at, so I intend to explore that a bit more. Now this other album is also the new app. How? Just attack me, listeners. Yes, it's the new ABBA album, but it includes a poster and postcard, and it's the vanilla release, for, you know, just probably the just black vinyl. I wanted a normal copy, and I wanted a sort of coloured vinyl version, and I did get a CD version as well, so I think I've bought at least three copies plus a
digital copy that you get anyway. So, yeah. So, yes. I think that's all my presents. So, yes, I have been spoiled.
Hey, Jay the Han Cub here. Thank you for calling. I'm sorry I can't be here to accept your call. Please leave a message at the tone and I will be back as soon as possible. Right now I'm out gathering spiders to build up my secret army. Thank you.
Oh, hi. Hi, Jay. You're not there, though. I was just ringing to... wish you a happy birthday. I know it's a few days ago, and I forgot. But, well, it's my birthday today, which reminded me it had been your birthday. Yeah, so I thought I ought to ring and say happy birthday, and then maybe you'd say happy birthday back. Maybe. Except that you're not there. You're probably having a lovely holiday somewhere, like a trip out somewhere. With Ron, yeah. I'm having a nice time. Yes, thank you for asking. I'm having a time. I'm in this spooky house. Yeah. It was all a bit last minute. I'm by myself, but I'm not by myself because the listeners are here. Yeah. You're not here, but well, you will be here. I'm sure you'll hear this at some point. Yeah. Anyway, I hope you're having a lovely time. Thank you for wishing me a happy birthday. I mean, you will say happy birthday, I'm sure, when you hear this. So I'm just saying thank you because you'll have said it. Anyway, better go. Catch up soon. All right. bye for now, Jay. Happy birthday. I hope you had a lovely time. I expect you're still having a lovely time. Many days after the event. I mean, when I say many days, it's only a few days. Two or three, or four, or five. Anyway, only a few days. Only some days. Yeah. I'm sure. Well, I wish I was there. I really do. Yeah. Bye now. Bye, Jay. Bye. Thanks. Bye. Bye.
Toppy, is that you? Hi, it's me, Paul again. Sorry, is it late?
Yeah, I was asleep. Paul, what's going on?
I don't think it's zombies, but I think it might be ghosts, because I went downstairs and the cellar door, although it was locked before, it was now open. Only ghosts can open locked doors. I don't want to go down. I don't want to go down to the cellar though, because what are they waiting for me? Or the ghosts could be waiting down there.
Well, Paul, it's really late here. You know, there's no. It's just. I think you are just letting your imagination run wild.
You know, ghost exists. I've met them before.
Well, but that's on your podcast, Paul. You know, so.
I'm not sure what you mean. I'm sorry I'm waking you up. Maybe I'll just put a chair against the door so that they can't come out. Oh, no.
Oh,
I guess
okay.
They could just come through the door, couldn't they?
That's a good idea.
Maybe I'll sleep in the garden.
No. Paul, you're fine.
The sun's coming up. The sun's coming up anyway, so maybe ghosts don't come out in the day.
It'll be fine. The sun's coming up. Paul, I got to... Oh, I gotta work tomorrow, and I'm, you know. Oh, that's all right. Sorry, just calm down, and it'll be fine.
Be well.
All right.
Bye night.
Okay.
Sorry.
Good night, Paul. Good night.
Hello, it's me again, Robot Cuthbert. Before we draw our episode to a close, we have another of Harry's new tunes. This one is called "Son of a Gun." We hope you like it. Following that, we have further Southern Park clips, which continue on from our earlier installment from April 1994, and then there are one or two more messages to share from the regulars. We're not quite done yet. There are some gems still to come. Enjoy! Exclamation.
I managed to get back, just about. It was very wet, and I got very wet. I don't really know why I went off to that wood, really. I don't know why. Anyway, it's I'm back. I'm back home, and I'm the phone's ringing now. The phone's ringing. I'm going to go and talk to Graham. Hi, Greg. Hello, yeah.
Hi Greg.
Hi, how are you? Have you finished with doing the interviews?
Yes, Paul.
You finished doing interviews?
Yes, Paul.
Look, you must stop taking those drugs. You really must. I'm sorry, you really must.
Yes,
so have you decided who's going to move in?
Yes, Paul.
In the spare bedroom?
Yes, Paul.
Okay, well, I'll leave you to watch some magic program.
Yes, Paul.
I'll go and see who it is then.
Yes,
don't tell me it is a secret.
Yes, Paul. Yes, Paul.
Okay.
Yes, Paul. Yes, Paul.
Strange, bro.
Yes, Paul.
Viewers, so I thought I'd go and see who's moved in. Could be quite exciting, I suppose. A new tenant in the house. They've picked a suitable lodger. Yeah. Right. I'll go and say hello. Shush, go away. Hello, excuse me.
Hello, have you noticed my thumb, viewers? I'm sorry, I went and hit my finger the other day. It's all this work. Yes, I went and hurt my finger, I'm sorry. It's all this stress and chasing claws. I'm not exactly sure how it happened. Anyway, hello, excuse me. Excuse me, I'm going out of focus. Okay, can I come in? Hello? Hello?
Hello, Paul. Hello. It's very nice to see you.
Oh. My goodness. My goodness. What are you doing here?
Why, Paul, didn't they tell you? Why, I live here now. I am the new tenant.
Oh, I see. Oh, it's nice to have you here.
Why, thank you, Paul. Why, thank you, Paul, yes. Well, let me just say, it's nice to be here.
You seem slightly shocked to see me, Paul.
How are things then, eh? Hmm?
Oh. Fine, yeah. Busy as usual. Thank you for getting rid of those evil slippers for me last time. You did get rid of them safely, didn't you? Yes?
What? Oh, yes. Oh, yes. I got rid of them. I was just smoothing in some of my stuff. Yeah. Yes, I got rid of them for you. I'm just sort of got a bit of work to do around here for a bit. To do with my job. He's a traveling salesman at the moment, you see. Means I'm moving around quite a bit. But, yes. Should be. I'm very glad of the kind of very cheap rent you have here as well. I must say, I do like the room. It is lovely. Yes.
Oh, well, I mustn't keep you. Got a few things to sort out. I think my friend Nick's coming over a little bit to do some work, and I've got to start a job. I'm starting a job myself actually on Monday, and yes. I'll leave you to it.
Oh, yes. You seen anything of the amphibian man recently? Have you seen anything of him? How's he going? Good chap.
He's fine. He's away at the moment. I'm not sure when he'll be coming back, if he'll be coming back. But yeah, nice to see you anyway. Yes. So the amphibian man. He's having a bit of a break, as I said. All the sort of trouble he's had with Southern Park recently. It's sort of got to him. He needs the break.
Yes, of course, it is quite, it's quite tiring when you're not used to it. Anyway, as I say, if you're getting in more trouble from Zuffenbach, I mean, I'm not actually working for them anymore, evilly. But if you need any assistance, then I will be there to help. If you do need any help, just give me a call, then I'm always around. Anyway, I'll see you about then. Okay. Thanks for popping in. Lovely evening. Yeah, I'll see you. Yeah. Right. Your pillows are not. I'll give you a call if anything happens. Thanks. See you about then. Thanks then. Bye.
Yeah, he seems like quite a nice plan, really, doesn't he?
Yes. It will be good living here. I will be able to carry out my plans. Paul is so foolish. He believes in me totally.
Ha 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 ha
Hello. Yeah, can you just tell us? I'm going to get right. Right, okay. Right. Aha. Yes, hello viewers. I'm going to go and just going to pick up Nick from the bus stop. He's coming to do some more editing this afternoon. So I'm just going to go and cycle and meet him. I'll see you in a minute. Well, there he is, viewers. Oh, it's Nick. Here he is. Oh. Hello, Nick.
Oh.
Hello. Oh.
Gosh.
Hello, I heard you were coming down on the bus, and I thought I'd come and meet you.
That's a good idea, yes. It's nice to be in Charlton again. It's really good.
I thought you were coming back to do some more editing and stuff.
Yes, the final edit.
Yes, yes. Lots to tell you anyway. Let's get back and have some
great
and get on with it.
Nice day.
So the bus made it then?
Yes.
Oh, good, good. Oh.
Yes, it's there's a car behind you.
Is that? Oh, dear. I'll probably get run over then.
Ah!
Yeah, fine. I don't know where to dump these books, I don't know. This room's full of Paul's junk. No, I'll leave it down there, I don't. What? Excuse me, are you a dinosaur? But what are you doing here? This is actually my room. You're one of Paul's lunatic. Nice people. Better be careful, just in case it's a spy. They want to get bad reports. Are you okay? You all right?
Hello? What's your name then? Hello?
Oh,
you can sing. Well, that's nice. Hello, let me. I think you've come in the wrong room. I live here now. Paul's in the other room, my dear. Well, why don't you go and why don't you go and see him? Hello? Hey?
Hello, viewers. Yes, hello. Yes, Nick's busy in there editing. I'm going to have another talk with him in a minute, but I don't want to disturb him just now. Yes. Paul, I found this, I actually found this dinosaur in your room. Well, in my room, actually. I wondered if you knew what, he or she was doing there.
Oh, it's Glenys.
Glenys? Who's she?
Oh, she lives here. How are you, Glenys? You okay? Not speaking very much. Oh, I'll come and see you in a minute. Metallic Man?
Yes?
Actually, have you got a name?
My name's, Geoffrey. Yes.
Oh, well, that's nice, yeah. Would you like to come and meet my friend Nick?
Yes. Yes, maybe I could.
Nick?
Paul, hi.
Hi, I just wanted you to meet... we've got a new lodger living at in the house. It's Metallic Man.
Hello. Nice to meet you. Nice to meet you, yes. I'm actually living... Yes, I'm living here, yes. Yes, nice to meet you. You're just over for the day, are you?
Yes, over for the editing on Saturday Park.
Very interesting. Yes. I'm just living here for a bit at the moment, and yes. Anyway, better be going. Right, goodbye. Yeah.
Okay. I'll.
He's gone. Don't worry. He's gone. He's a bit of a strange bloke, but
Paul. He was with the baddies, though, wasn't he?
He used to be with the baddies, yeah. But he's. I mean, I know he sounds a bit disinterested about the filming, but you know, not everyone can be interested in it.
Are you sure you can trust him, though?
Oh yes, he's okay now. He's okay. Don't worry.
Sorry, Toppy. I just had to ring you back very quickly. I'm sorry. Oh, I hope you hadn't gone to sleep again.
You called half an hour ago. Sorry, what's going on?
So I don't think it's ghosts, but what about, I've got a tick list. What about if it was werewolves or aliens? What if it was that Gorgon? The Gorgon that we met that turned me to stone.
Checklist?
Yeah, I'm just trying to work out what it isn't, but then I know how to confront it.
Gorgon. Paul.
Werewolves.
Why are you so nervous?
This house. It's just this house is very creepy. Even now it's getting Even now it's getting light. You're quite creepy. Well,
light'll be good, Paul. Light'll be good. The sun is cleansing and purifying.
I ruled out vampires because.
Good. You've ruled out.
Well, although vampires aren't necessarily like they used to be, I think there are quite a few vampires. Some vampires can actually stand the sun these days because it always was one of those things that was kind of a vain, stupid sort of flaw for them to have.
Stupid, yeah. Paul, you're talking a mile a minute. Have you been awake all this time?
Yeah, I've just been drinking coffee and staying awake. I'm hoping that I'll hear from Harry. Maybe he'll turn up and then I can send him down into the cellar.
It's time to put the coffee down, Paul. Okay?
All right. Okay.
Look, I just think you need to... You're just getting overly excited and... I'm sure the sun will help. The sun will help. Yeah.
Well, it is actually my birthday now, though. It's actually my birthday because you said I got a bit early. It's actually my birthday.
Happy birthday, Paul.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you. I'll let you go to bed. Thank you. Sorry. Okay. I'll call you later.
Much later. Okay. Like tomorrow. Afternoon. Okay. All right.
No. Bye. Sorry. Bye.
Okay. No. Good night. Okay.
What was I saying? Yes, last week I was shocked. I was on 4 out of 5 episodes of Big Fatty Online last week. 4 out of 5. I don't, well, to be fair, it wasn't just me, but I made it onto Big Fatty's opening as well, which only the second time, but it's always a thrill to be on Big Fatty's opening. And yes, between Ick and I, we also managed to be on 3 other episodes. Ick has been, to be fair, I'm really proud of Ick. It's been so lovely to have him sort of around. I know we've kind of lost the sort of mob of aliens that was living here, but then that always was a bit chaotic.
It's not just ruined, it's me, Big Fatty, online.
But it's always a thrill to be on Big Fatty's opening.
Yes! Well, hello everyone, it is the Fat One, and this is episode 2591 of a BFO for Wednesday the 10th of November, 2021, y'all. Coming up on today, say it with me. Show. Y'all, I'm going to try to catch you up on what's been happening with Big Fatty over the past 2 days, Big Fatty. Yeah, Gussie, y'all, before I get into the celebration of exiting the birth canal today, y'all, you know how I'd complain that I couldn't drag the music directly from my Apple Snack music into the banjo band? Well, y'all, I can now for some songs. Not all of them, but some of them. And y'all, it's as much a mystery as to why it stopped working as to why it's now partially working. Big Fatty. But anyway, let's move on to the important Disney. The important business. Y'all, today, the 10th of November. Y'all, it's a very important celebration of exiting the birth canal. Y'all never met this person face-to-face, but y'all, they have been a major supporter of the BFO for years, I tell you. Y'all, you heard him at the beginning of today's little show. Y'all, I am talking about none other than the Shy Yeti and Ick. Big Fatty, we love the Shy Yeti and Ick. We do indeed. And, y'all, you know, he does his abominable Yeti cast. Yes, Big Fatty. And it's not that it's abominable. It's the Yeti is the abominable snowman. Yes, that's what I meant, Big Fatty. Anyway, he puts out more shows than Granny puts out gravel out of his butt. Big Patty, please. But, y'all, if you see a shy Yeti or Ick the alien on the Twitty or the Face, wish them a happy celebration of exiting the birth canal. And Big Fatty, I hope they both get a big old piece of cake. At the beginning of today's little show, y'all, you heard the birthday boy, the Shy Yeti, and Shy Yeti, what's your birthday wish?
But it's always a thrill to be on Big Fatty's opening.
Oh, well, Big Fatty's opening was a little bit busy. Yet the Big Fatty, you're vulgar.
You can leave a comment on the website at BigFattyOnline.com, and you don't have to use the www. Or drop me an e-letter at ruined@BigFattyOnline.com. Or call the brand new voice letter number at 619-784-6331. That's 619-RUINED-1. And ask a question or just natter with the fat one. Yes! This has been a presentation of the RNL Podcasting Network and a proud member of Pride 48.
Hello, Paul. It's me and Martin. We're here. Hi, Cromarty. How are you? How are you, Martin?
I'm fine, yes. I'm all right.
How was your course?
Oh, yes. It was fantastic. Yes. It was about technology and smells and, you know, things like that.
Right. Technology and smells. Were you on the same course, Cromarty? Well, yes, I was, I feel like I wanted to know more. I wanted to support Martin as well. Yes. Well, that's fair enough. Yes, that's fair enough. I'm glad you learned something. Yes, Paul, very much so. How has your birthday been? Oh, yeah. Kind of all right, I suppose. Yeah. I think I probably upset Toppy. I was having naps and stuff, and you know how it goes. I kept ringing him up and forgetting what the time difference was, and yeah. When was this, Paul? Well, you see, I arrived yesterday, you know, last night. So, effectively, it was my birthday. But, it was very early hours of my birthday. But it was, I kept hearing noises and creaks. And I thought maybe it was things that go bump in the night. Well, Paul, are you not used to those sorts of things? Well, yes. Yes, I am. It's a bit different when you're by yourself, in a way, you know. Why did you not speak to the things that made you go bump? Well, they didn't make me go bump. Oh, I'm sorry, Paul. I misunderstood. No, that's an expression. The things that go bump in the things that were disturbing me. Why didn't I go and speak to them? Yes, Paul, that's what I meant. I didn't even know if they existed, whether it was my imagination. I had a bit of cider. I was excited, overexcited. I'm not sure there was anyone at all here. I think it may have been my imagination. That's it. That's all. I think I was just being silly. You know how these things are. You get carried away. Oh dear, Paul. I hope you haven't made a nuisance of yourself. Mr. Toppy Smelly.
I'm sure he'll be fine. You know, he's very accommodating.
Yes, he is. Yes, as I'm sure Yeti Uncle John would confirm. You what?
Don't say that. Cup of tea.
Oh, I'm sorry. What's going on, guys?
No, Cromarty just meant, you know, Toppy travelled all that way to see Eddie Uncle John in Shame Jail, and it was a lot, you know, a long way to go. Anyway.
Yes, he did. When was it he came? It was just around the same time as he escaped, wasn't it? Guys.
Now you've done it.
I didn't mean to say anything. Guys, I just have a question. Have you any idea how he might have escaped? You know, I never quite bought the idea that that his friends inside the jail would have been able to get him out, and then they didn't try and escape too. I have no idea, Paul. No idea at all.
Well, you know, you don't know how jail works, especially shame jail, Paul.
I suppose not. I'm just glad that Dobby didn't travel all this way and then not get to see him. That would have been awful to have turned up and the person you're visiting has escaped. Oh, dear. Well, I better let you go. Glad your course went okay. What are you going to do this evening, Paul? I've got a couple of horror films to watch. One of them was a present from Nick. Oh, it sounds good, Paul. Well, we'll see you soon. Sorry we could not be there with you in person. No, quite understand.
Yeah, we'll see you soon.
Yeah, see you soon, Martin. Take care, both of you. Say hi to everyone. Any news from Ick? No, well, we heard that he's having fun, you know, in a sort of genteel type way. You know, that's the main thing. Okay, speak to you soon. Bye now. Bye-bye. Goodbye, Paul. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Hello, Mum. It's my birthday. Happy birthday.
You don't want me to sing, do you?
You can do.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Paul. Happy birthday to you.
Very good. I think you should probably...
That's my posh voice.
You probably deserve a... Yeah, mothers should get a present on the birthdays of their children, I think.
I entirely agree. So 10:30 tonight, I expect to have a large bunch of flowers delivered to me, okay?
Yes, it's coming. It's on its way.
Yeah. Graham was more civilised. It was afternoon tea, 4:00.
It's the only time he has been civilised. I'm not sure what
I remember it more than you do.
Yeah, I don't remember much of anything. Only the photos. Well, I don't remember those photos happening. Of like when I was a bit older.
Yes. Well, you've got a very good memory, much better than me. I thought I was going to go back to about the age of 11, I think.
I wish
a few months at primary school.
Because I did meet Uncle Jim and my granddad, didn't I? But I just don't remember it. Only just.
No, because your granddad died when you were about 8 months old, I think.
But did I not meet him?
Yes, you did. Yeah. Oh, yes, because
I thought there were pictures at the christening.
Village. Uncle Jim... They came to your christening, but they lived in Reading, so that may have been the only time you saw it. I can't remember. It wasn't that much later he died, but I can't remember exactly when. Mm. Of course, you remember Auntie Jessie.
Yes, of course. Anyway, thank you for your birthday singing.
It's a pleasure. I don't know whether you can say that.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm so glad I caught you, Paul. Oh, I didn't know what was going on. I didn't really go on much about where I was going, and everyone's been out on courses and X in space and Bettina and August have gone off somewhere. Oh well, you know. Still, you went to a scary house for your birthday. Yeah, it's sort of scary, you know, as they go. I wasn't really in the mood for it, I must say. I wasn't really in the mood for being in a scary house. You're saying you'd rather have stayed at home with Dealey and Toby? Well, I wouldn't go quite that far, but yeah, maybe. Still, oh, no, it's been fine. Actually, I was talking to Cromarty and Martin earlier. Your name came up. Oh, yes. Well, because of Toppy, I ended up getting a bit drunk and calling Toppy far too many times. I lost track of time. And we were talking about when he came to visit you. It's a good thing you hadn't escaped already. Oh, no, Paul, I don't think that wouldn't have been possible. Sorry? I'll just say... No, I'm not saying anything. Just saying, it wouldn't have been possible that I would have escaped as early as that because there were too many guards around. Because of it being visiting hours. Yeah, we were just saying it's a good thing because, you know, Toppy came all that way. yes. That's true. That's very true, yes. Oh, well, I better let you go. Yes, I've got to make another call, so, Right, happy birthday, Paul. Enjoy your film night. Thank you, I will, yes. All right. Cheers. I'll be in touch once I'm back. Yes, Paul, all right, yes, all right. Cheers. Bye now. Well, listeners, I suppose I'll have some, I don't know, soup or something for tea. I don't know, I had quite a big lunch. And I had it late as well. Yeah, still. Well, you know, it's not been a bad birthday. Just been a little quieter than I expected. I had presents and cards. I spoke to Toppy on a number of occasions. I must apologise to him. I feel bad. I just got a bit carried away. So I'm going to watch my films, and I'll say goodbye for now, I think, because next thing I know it'll be bedtime. And thank you for being here. Thank you for sharing my birthday with me. And I'll be in touch. We'll be back soon. Yeah. Okay. Cool. Okay. You take care. Bye bye for now. Bye bye. Bye now. Bye bye. Toppy, it's me.
Paul, it was just 15 minutes ago. I'm sorry. You know, I'm trying to sleep here, Paul. What is it?
No, it's later than you think. I think you might have
think you might have slept through your alarm. It's about 4 hours since
Okay. Paul, it's four hours later. What's going on?
I know what happened. I know. I'm having a brunch. Yeah, I found out who it was in the house.
Who was it?
I went for a list. Was it a burglar? Was it a zombie? Was it a ghost?
Your TikTok list.
Yeah, was it a gorgon? Turns out it was all of them. So I've got Jeff here. He was a burglar.
He's a friendly
burglar.
I was going to say Jeff the Gorgon. That would be fun.
No. Friendly Jeff the burglar. Zombie. There's a zombie guy. There's a couple of ghosts. They were living in the cellar.
Two ghosts.
A little werewolf, and an alien gorgon. Not the one that turned me into stone. I don't know everybody's name yet, but they've just come back. The werewolf went out and got stuff from Master Spencer's for breakfast.
You're having brunch with them?
Yeah. They didn't realize that. I think what's been happening is that. So this is like a house that you rent, but I think there may be an agency that rents out to humans, but there might also be an agency that rents out to natural beasties. So there's obviously been double booking. So these guys were coming here for some supernatural party. And I'm here we've all agreed to live together. It's fine. Hopefully I'll talk to them later.
Well, I've never known zombies and vampires to get along together, but okay. Are you sure you're all right, Paul?
Yes.
They're sitting around now.
On the kitchen table.
And you're having brunch. What are you guys eating?
Oh, we've got pancakes and bacon. They even bought me a birthday cake. They were very, very.
They bought you a birthday cake.
When they found out it was my birthday, they had to celebrate. They've been very generous. I'll be there. Yeah, I'll be there in a minute. Thank you. Yes, it's fine.
I can't believe this. This is amazing.
They're good company. One of them's got a cracking sense of humour, but I haven't told them that I'm a podcaster yet.
They might
be a bit shocked.
I'll probably should keep that a secret. Do they have good manners? I mean, are they, you know, do they know how to use fork?
Well, the werewolf's eating out of a bowl at the moment.
Of course.
In his wolfies, very... He transferred, but transmogrified, whatever. So we put his food down in a bowl. But it's a bit like having a sheepdog in the house or something. He's not violent. He's not trying to eat anybody.
Well, that's good. I hope there's no garlic in the brunch, because that, you know, the vampire guy would be like,
The alien is definitely a different sort of alien from Ick. So
sure. Tentacles, slime, what do we got?
They're different. Sort of tall and debonair, but with three heads.
Yeah, but he's eating a lot then.
Yes, he does. Yes, but as they bought it, the food, I don't feel I should. can't really make comments. The zombie is more animated than I expected. He's eating cornflakes.
You are so weird, Paul. Okay. What? All right. Well, I mean, this is going to make a memorable birthday then, I guess. The day, it's like the movie of this would be like All Monsters Brunch.
Yeah. Monster Brunch.
Yeah.
I don't know if Harry's coming, but I'll have to break it to him. I think he might be looking.
You might want to warn him. Give him a little heads up, Paul.
Have you missed your alarm? Are you late? You're going to be late for work.
I guess I did. I am.
Sorry. Late. My fault.
You know what might have caused that? 50 million phone calls last night.
I'm sorry.
Oh my God.
At least you can be reassured that all my worries were genuine.
Yeah. There's that. Paul, yeah, you better, you know, get him some RT or something. I don't know. Paul, this has been very interesting. And
That's what you're going to say.
Very, very weird. All right, Paul, I got to go to work, okay?
Birthday.
Right. Yeah, happy birthday.
Thank you. Okay. Bye, Toppy. Thanks. But,
goodbye.
Bye.
Goodbye.
Bye.
Goodbye. Goodbye.
Bye.
Goodbye. This show is part of the Pride 48 Network. Find more shows over at pride48.com.
Oh, dear. What's going on now?
Oh, it's the Shy Life Podcast.
Let's go.
I have a voice.
I have a voice.
You have a voice.
You have a voice.
We have a voice.
We have a voice.
Unique voices in podcasting.
Univazpods.net.
Cromarty, it's Uncle John's calling. He seems a bit concerned.
Oh, right, yes, okay. Thank you. Yeti, Uncle John, what's wrong? Peace, are you by yourself? Well, you know, Paul's not here, so he won't hear. What's wrong? Oh, I'm concerned. I nearly gave myself away. Oh, Yeti, Uncle John, what did you say? Oh, well, you know, I just, he said that he talked to you and that it was a good thing that I hadn't escaped before Toppy arrived that time, and I sort of said, well, that wouldn't have been possible because I was thinking, well, no, it was the stuff that helped me escape. But I realised who I was talking to, and I just said, no, what I meant is that there were too many guards around. Oh, Yeti, Uncle John. Are you sure Paul doesn't know that Toppy was involved? Not that I'm aware of, or if he is, then he's keeping it to himself. Oh, dear, oh, dear. Are you cross with me, Cromarty? I'd understand if you were cross with me. No. No, I almost said something myself. I was a bit grumpy and I said something and I was able to backtrack. It was something very much like what you said, but oh dear. I don't like keeping secrets like this. But I don't want Toppy getting in trouble. No, of course not. I understand. Those two have been friends for years. Don't want them falling out over this. I'm totally to blame, even though if Toppy had just said, no, I won't do it, then there wasn't anything I could have done about it. Yes, Yeti, Uncle John, but don't blame him. No, I know, what you mean. I won't. I'm sure he doesn't know anything. He's too busy thinking about his birthday and being all sad. Oh, dear. He's such a drama queen. I'm sure he could have made better plans or more sociable plans with other friends. If he really had wanted to. Well, yes, that's what I thought, but, well, you know, midweek birthdays, everyone's busy working, you know, I don't know. I'm sure he's having a great film night. He's probably really enjoying himself. I do hope so. I really do hope so. Oh, I'm very excited. It's nearly time for the film night. I've invited lots of the locals, yes, they're mostly zombies and ghosts and ghoulies and things like that. But hopefully they'll come and watch the film with me. Yeah, I'm sure they'll turn up. I hope they'll turn up. I've got really good horror films. Yeah, who could resist? I Don't Want to Be Born with Joan Collins. Come on, now you're talking. Yeah, they should be here any minute now. I think I might need to open that gin. Oh, good old Milo. He does know what a Yeti needs. He really does. Oh, yes. Happy birthday to me. Happy birthday to me. Happy birthday, dear me. Happy birthday, dear me.
Wake up, Paul. It's your birthday.
What?
It's your birthday.
Oh, sorry, I just must have dozed off.
You dozed off? It's the 10th of November.
10th of November. Happy birthday to me.
Happy birthday to you. What are you
going to
do?
I don't know. I thought that I didn't think I was planning that much. I certainly didn't know you were coming. So that's just a nice surprise.
Just pop in and...
Yeah. I suppose we could go out somewhere or have a meal somewhere or...
It's a bit gloomy, but it's perfectly, it's dry.
Yeah, we could go to a nightclub. We could go to the theatre. We could go to the cinema. We could go anywhere. We could do loads of things.
Nightclub? Yeah. I went to it very briefly with work the other day, and can't remember much about it. So.
Does that mean you had a good time, or you don't remember?
According to the video I did, but I can't remember anything that was on that video that turned up on Facebook, so that's not good. But my sensible self says my clubbing days are over, but is that 53 now, Dave, from here? I always hold out a little hope.
I'm kind of surprised that I'm suggesting going to a nightclub, because I'm not exactly it's kind of weird. It's kind of weird.
It's your birthday. It's your birthday.
The best part of the Shy Life podcast is when it ends.
But I've heard that Paul's extremely nimble.
Now that one was funny.